Hello, my friend. Stay a while and listen.
Today we're looking at the Soul Shards and how they will impact leveling in Season 25 of Diablo 3. Now, this is some kind of basic information, so even if, let's say, you don't try and apply this to your leveling, hopefully speaking there's something in here for you that will help you understand the Season theme, maybe just a little better, maybe give you some options moving forward in terms of how to get the Soul Shards, where to get them, which ones to go for, and that type of thing. Before we do jump in though, as always guys, a thumbs up is greatly appreciated. Chuck me a comment on the video, which class are you starting with? I'm probably going to go Demon Hunter or Monk. Both look pretty strong, and yeah, I think this season is going to be an awful lot of fun. Now, when we start off leveling, obviously there's various different methods that we can use. We can go for rifting, we can go cursed chests, we can just, you know, play the game naturally. This is probably more of a kind of solo guide, because normally if you're in a party of four people, you'll blast through it pretty quick. Now, we're going to talk about some targeting with the gems, with the Soul Shards, which are the new season theme. We're also going to talk about them just in general, because you might just pick them up as you go. Now, the way to actually target them is to do bosses, because we do know that they have a higher drop chance from bosses. In the background, you should be looking up some footage that I've filmed trying to get them. The drop rate is pretty good, but we need to bear in mind that we are on PTR, and we do have this like 2000% legendary increased drop chance. Now, I'm not sure if this applies to the shards. It may well do, but they're not technically, I don't think, a legendary item, because it's not like when we don't get a shard, we get a legendary when we kill a lot of the enemies. So I kind of think they're on their own basis. So being really optimistic, it will be that the shards drop pretty often. So we're talking like 75% plus of the time when you kill a boss, even at level one on normal difficulty, which is the footage in the background. I'm guessing that the chance does go up a little bit as you increase the difficulty. You know, sometimes you can get two drops. Again, doing some stuff on T16, sometimes you do get two drops. And I think I have had some times when you get none. So you just need to bear in mind, there's no guarantee you're going to get them. But the chance, I do think, is pretty good. Hey guys, it's Filthy. Just a quick insert here. I've talked about targeting these Soul Shards. What I would say is the ones from Act 1 and Act 2, you can get just almost immediately. The ones from later on, just make sure you're level 20. It just seems to be the safest. I haven't gone and tested like level 15, level 14, 16, 17, etc. But I've just done an Act 4 one with a level 20 character. And as you can see, we've got the Sliver of Terror and Remnant of Pain. So you can go and get the Act 2 and Act 1 ones straight away with a level 1 character. Other than that, I probably would be level 20 just to be on the safe side. I hope this helps. Back to the video. So let's go through them now. The way that these Soul Shards work is you can use them at level 1. You have to upgrade them using Hellforge Embers. You're not going to have any Hellforge Embers, I don't think, until certainly after 70. I didn't notice any of these dropping when I have leveled characters on PTR. I guess theoretically it is possible, but it's going to be very, very hard. So we're just going to deal with the base gems today. Now, there are three that go in the helm. These are the Shard of Hatred. We've got the Sliver of Terror and also the Fragment of Destruction. We've got four that go in weapons, which are the Drag of Lies, the Remnant of Pain, Essence of Anguish, and also the Stain of Sim. Now, first off, obviously a socket is going to be very handy. So you're either going to need a helm with a socket in, so you can either pick one up, craft one at Hadrig, or reroll at the Mystic. And the same goes for the weapon. You obviously are going to have a socket on there. So again, reroll, craft, or just find one. Now, the first one, the Shard of Hatred, this is farmable by doing bosses, and the bosses that we can do are the Act 5 ones. This is Urziel, Malthiel, and Adria. Now, it gives you 15% reduced damage when you have three or fewer enemies within 25 yards. That's the negative effect. So if you're fighting three or fewer enemies, you deal less damage. But if you have more than three enemies within that distance, you deal 10% increased damage per enemy up to 100. So if you find one of these, this would be useful for cursed chest leveling, for massacre bonus leveling in dense areas, because you're looking to get that secondary effect, more than three enemies, up to 100% damage. How much useful is this for leveling? I'd say pretty debatable. If you're quite good at cursed chest leveling, doing something with the necro with corpse explosion possibly, or just any kind of decent AoE-ish kind of build might be good. So, you know, if you want to go pick that up, absolutely you can. Now the next one is the Sliver of Terror. I think this is probably the best one to get. Cooldowns are increased by 25%. That's the negative. Obviously, as you are leveling, you don't really have much cooldown reduction. You pretty much have none the whole time. But for every skill you do have on cooldown, you get 12.5% reduced damage, so damage reduction, and you also get 25% increased damage. So, you know, theoretically, you've got 6 skills on your bar, so that's 150% damage. But obviously, it's going to be very hard to keep 6 skills on cooldown. You know, you've got generators and spenders are very popular. You know, things like corpse explosion and necro, I don't think actually goes on cooldown. So, you know, realistically, for the Sliver of Terror, I think you're probably going to end up with about 3 or 4 skills. So if you just took 4 skills, it's 100% extra damage provided you're, you know, keeping things on cooldown. And that damage reduction, you know, 4 times 12.5 is 50%. So that is pretty useful. You can get this from Act 4 bosses. So that is Diablo, Izul, and Rakanoth. Do bear in mind though that they also drop the Remnant of Pain, although I would say that is a pretty good gem for the weapon, so that is certainly a good potential early thing to do, is to do a few Diablo, Izul, Rakanoth runs until you get either the Sliver of Terror or the Remnant of Pain. So I'd say that's probably the best one. Now, the worst, I think, in my opinion, is going to be the Fragments of Destruction. This allows you to move unhindered through enemies. That could be useful, but the other negative effect, I think, is pretty bad. So each enemy you pass through gets a mark of destruction for 7 seconds. When an enemy marked with this dies, it takes 1 second off your skill cooldowns. So that could be pretty handy. But if the mark expires before the enemy dies, you lose 2% of your maximum health as damage, and marks are not applied if you're below 35% health. So realistically, the only thing you're getting out of this is some cooldown. That's if you kill the enemy within the time frame. Sometimes that can be difficult, sometimes it's not going to go right and you're just going to lose health. So I'd say this probably for leveling would be the weakest choice, but maybe there's something you could play around with the cooldowns. Now, if you do want to pick this one up, this is in the Act 3 loot pool. So this is Gome. It is the Siegebreaker, Cydia, and Asmodam. And yeah, they're the options for the Helms. Now, the weapons, the Dreg of Lies, this is obtainable through Act 2. So this is Belial, Magda, and Zoltan Kul. It's either a gem that is very useful to you or completely and utterly worthless. So what it does is it makes your character deal 25% less damage. That's the negative effect, but the positive is that your pets deal 50% increased damage. Obviously, if you're using pets, that's a pretty nice damage increase. And if you're not using pets, well, you're just hindering yourself. So don't put this in unless you've got a pet build. So this is things like Necromancer, trying to use the skeletons. Necro with the corpse explosion probably could cover this. It wouldn't really matter if you knock 25% damage off because it hits so hard. But unless it's a completely pet-focused build, you know, you do need to be a little careful. Where I think this would shine is if you're leveling a monk, because the mystic allies will count as pets, obviously, and then a lot of the supporting items for that are in the loot pool. So I think this is an excellent shout if you are going to play monk. So I would go and pick up Dragonflies if you're planning to use some pets. Now, the next one that we've got is the Remnant of Pain. Crit chance is reduced by 15%. Obviously, you don't start with much crit chance early on in the game, so that is the negative side of it. But attacks against incapacitated enemies are automatically crits. Now, incapacitated, I haven't tested this, so if anybody has in the comments, do shout up and let us know. But I'm guessing this is any form of crowd control. It might be a hard CC, so it might be like freeze, stun, something that affects the ability to move and target. I'm not sure whether slow applies, but obviously if you can get something with a high degree of, you know, maybe fear on hit, maybe stun on hit, then automatically critting is going to be worth quite a lot. So, you know, again, depending on the class you're playing, depending on what skills you've got, this could be worth picking up. Now, for this one that we've already covered, it is in the Izul, Diablo, and also Rakanoth, so Act 4 bosses. So again, if you can work in that incapacitated effect, then that paired with the, you know, extra damage from things on cooldown and damage reduction, you could absolutely blast your way with the Remnants of Pain and also the Sliver of Terror. Moving on, we've got the Essence of Anguish. Obviously, again, this is one that is either completely useless to you or very useful. Only really applies to a couple of classes, actually. So every time you deal poison damage to an enemy, you increase your cooldown reduction and move speed by 2.5%. So that's good, up to 10 stacks. So 25% move speed, 25% cooldown. But the damage you take is increased by 5% for 10 seconds. So again, stacking up to 50%. So only really Necro and Witch Doctor do poison. I don't think any of the other classes have poison, so you obviously would have to do poison damage, but again, could be pretty good for Necro Corpse Explosion, which loves a bit of poison. You can pair it with things like a Nair's Black Death, which is a poison Necro weapon. 50% extra damage, that can be rough, particularly if you're trying to push the envelope with those, you know, higher like torment levels whilst leveling. But again, it's something you kind of need to bear in mind yourself. Now, we get this from Act 1, so this is Queen Arane, the Butcher, the Skeleton King. Again, fairly easy to pick up, and only really do it if you've, one, hitting with poison, and two, feel like you can cope with this 50% extra incoming damage. And this leaves, last, is the Stain of Sin. Now, this is an interesting one. I'd say this is probably the most useless out of all of them. You deal 25% less damage. Again, that's the negative, not very good. When you kill 50 enemies, you spawn a pool of blood that increases damage done to elites by 150% and lasts 15 seconds. Now, really, the only use I could see for this during leveling is going to be rifting, because otherwise you're not going to probably see enough elites to make that worthwhile. The 25% damage reduction just sounds like a pain, and killing 15 enemies, hoping that the pool of blood goes in the right place, hoping that, you know, the elites go around you, it just seems like a complete pain. But if you do want to pick this one up, this is Asmodam, Gome, Siegebreaker, Cydia, so Act 3 bosses. Now, obviously, as you do find the Hellforge Embers, you can unlock the extra powers, and these gems do all come into their own, but you still obviously can use the knowledge of where to farm them to go get them. You can obviously try and target one. You know, if you know that you want a really nice Shard of Hatred, then you know you have to keep hitting Azeal, Malthiel, and Aedra from Act 5, and you just have to keep upgrading with your embers and see how lucky you get on the extra bits and bobs. Now, there are obviously negatives that come with using these things that aren't listed here, because let's say you do have a socket on your helm or a socket in your weapon. Normally speaking, you'd be putting in a ruby in your helm for XP. Now, you're not going to unlock any of the XP benefits of these until later ranks, so you've got to bear in mind you're going to get a little bit less XP for that. Also, you could be buffing up your toughness with a amethyst. So again, there is a negative side to putting one of these in. And same for the weapon. You normally are adding rubies for extra plus damage. So again, you have to make the call. Is it worth doing one of these, or is it worth doing one of the others? Now, leveling is a pretty dynamic process anyway, in terms of what legendary items you find, you know, as to what skills you go and what builds you go for. There are general templates that we can use, but one of the things that I do think is pretty cool about this season theme is with these additions, it does actually open up some interesting choices. Maybe you can go and pick some of these and build something a little bit different to normal. But I think what I'm planning to do is, if I go for Monk, I'm definitely going to get the pet one. That's what I'm going to try and hope to find. And also the Sliver of Terror. They're the two that I would really like to pick up as a Monk. If I go Demon Hunter, I probably will just play and see what I can find. Maybe I'll go for the Sliver of Terror again and try and pick it up, because I do think that is probably the number one shining star of this. That is the video, guys. I hope you found it useful. Obviously, again, as you progress through the game, these things get more and more powerful. Unlocking the extra tiers will start to shred stuff. Yeah, I'm looking forward to the season. I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope it has been useful. I hope you've learned something. I'll be back just as soon as I can with some more videos soon.